यूनिट्स एंड डाइमेंशंस, एरर्स एंड मेजरमेंट्स. यूनिट्स एंड डाइमेंशंस एंड एरर्स एंड मेजरमेंट्स. सो ऑलरेडी यू नो द एंटायर स्टोरी ऑफ यूनिट्स एंड डाइमेंशंस. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल बेसिकली यूनिट्स विल बी, हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ यूनिट्स विल बी देयर, फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज. हाउ मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज, टू टाइप्स ऑफ फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज, राइट. वन इज फंडामेंटल, अनदर इज डिराइव्ड. यू डोंट नो दैट, आई थॉट यू नो, एंड देन आई सेड यू नो एंटायर स्टोरी लाइक दैट. सो दिस इज नॉट, बाय द वे दिस इज नॉट नेसेसरी फॉर द नीड, बट यू शुड गेट टू नो व्हाट हैपनिंग देयर. सो हियर फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज आर बेसिकली टू टाइप्स. व्हाट आर द फिजिकल क्वांटिटीज? नथिंग बट, see that definitions and all will not come for the need, and then you know what is physical quantity means, that's enough. You know, right? At least idea you are having, so there is no need to remember any definitions and all. So physical quantities are two types, whatever all the mass, length, time and all are there, no? Even velocities, acceleration, force, work, energy, everything we call it as physical quantities. So that physical quantities will be two types, in that basically fundamental, another is derived quantities. Fundamental nothing but by using nothing but we'll get basic quantities, nothing but mass. Mass cannot be derived from anything. Length is a basic unit, length cannot be derived from anything. Time, and also ampere, nothing but current, electric current, and also substance of what is that, molarity we call it as, no, amount of substance. Then luminous intensity, these and all are the basic physical quantities, nothing but those are the basic quantities. From that only we can derive others, but from others we cannot derive these quantities. Those are the basic quantities, the basic measurements we will take. Those are the mass, length, time, electric current, temperature, then amount of substance, then luminous intensity. These are the basic quantities, fundamental physical quantities, and that will be represented in different units, in different types. Whenever you take the mass, in terms of CGS units it will be what, grams. In terms of SI unit that will be what, kg. Like that all the quantities will be in different methodology will represent that. And also derived quantities nothing but we make the physical quantities by using the fundamental quantities. So whenever I want to make the velocity is equals to, what is the formula for us? Distance by time, correct. Length by time we'll take, so that length is also fundamental quantity only, time is also fundamental quantity only, so that we can take it as distance by time. And also whenever you see the work is equals to, what is the formula? Force into displacement. Force is nothing but what again? Mass into acceleration. So that mass into acceleration into the displacement. Displacement is however length only, right? That is one of the fundamental quantity. Here mass is also another fundamental quantity. Then what about the acceleration? Meter per second square. Otherwise what we can say, velocity by time, otherwise distance by time square, anything we can take. Again distance is basic quantity, and then time is a basic quantity. So fundamental quantity is nothing but which will not depend on anything, that will not depend on anything, just those are the fundamental quantities. Derived quantities nothing but by using the fundamental quantities only we'll make the derived quantities. That might be velocity, acceleration, work, force, anything it might be. Except this, all the physics formulas and then all the physics quantities are derived quantities only, except these seven whatever we got here. So here mass is one of the fundamental quantity, length, time, electric current is also fundamental quantity only, temperature, Kelvin temperature also fundamental quantity, and also amount of substance, moles, molarity, that is also fundamental quantity, and also luminous intensity we'll measure in optics we will get that, what is the light value will be there, intensity we have to measure nothing but we'll take it as candelas, in terms of candela we'll measure that. Okay, in these physical quantities will be represented in system of units. Mainly those system of units are CGS units, and also FPS units, and also MKS units. CGS, FPS and then MKS. So here CGS unit. CGS unit nothing but C is nothing but what? Centimeter, gram and second. So whatever the basic physical quantities, whatever these three physical quantities are there, no, that we will represent in different units in different formations. So whenever you see in CGS, the mass will be represented in what? Grams. And also length will be represented in what? Centimeters. Time will be represented in seconds. And also whenever you go to the FPS system, FPS nothing but foot, pound and then second. So that the mass will be represented in terms of pounds. You might be seeing that LB. Okay, in 1 kg nothing but 450 LB, they will say that. 1 kg nothing but we will take 1000 grams, right? In 1000 grams nothing but 450 LB. Otherwise 1 kg is equals to 0.452 pounds we will take. And those are not necessary, by the way. So we have to represent the quantities in different system of units nothing but grams will be in terms of pounds, and then the length will be in terms of what? Foot. Length will be in terms of foot, and also second will be second only. Time is second only. Then whenever you come to the mass again in MKS system, mass will be represented in terms of what? Kilograms. And then length will be represented in what? Meters. Meters. And then time will be represented in seconds. Clear? These are the different representation of units. In that mainly we will use this CGS units and also this MKS units. In this MKS units also one more thing will be there, that is SI units. Standard International Units. So that from all the countries around the world will be accepted by one system of units, not by all. This one we will not measure anything in foods and then pounds. Always we'll measure the mass in terms of what? Kilograms only, right? Kilograms or grams. So that we did not take in this one as our standard quantity. So that this is not a standard quantity. And always we will tell what the mass and then length and then time we will represent in meters or kilometers. Otherwise this one kilograms and then seconds. So this is also a basic what representation only, but the standard system of units is different. That is SI units. Internationally standard system of units, that is internationally accepted units. So those are, first of all, in this mass will be represented in what? Kg. And also length will be in terms of what? Meters. And then time will be what? Seconds. And then next one is what? Electric current. Electric current will be represented in what? Amperes, right? Amperes. And the symbol is what? A. And then seconds nothing but S. And then meters is M. And then meters is M. L. Meters is L. And then kg is what? Mass is M. Otherwise the symbols directly if you write kg and then meters is nothing but small m. Whenever you are writing 2 meters. 2 meters nothing but how we will represent? These are the dimensions. How we will represent the meters? Small m only, right? 10 meters if you say. And also kilograms is kg only. And also next one is temperature. Temperature is what? Kelvin. Celsius is not standard unit. Kelvin is the standard unit. So that is Kelvin. What is the symbol? K is the symbol. Then next one is amount of substance. Amount of substance, that is mole. How to represent that? Symbol is what? MOL. In chemistry always you will get MOL. Then luminous intensity. Intensity is candela. Will represent what? CD. Those are the representation in standard international system. So this is a standard international system in that mass will be represented in kilograms. We'll measure the mass in kilograms. The symbol is what? Kg. Length will be measured in meters. The symbol is what? M. Time will be measured in seconds. The symbol is S. And then current will be measured in amperes. The symbol is what? A. And then temperature will be measured in Kelvin. The symbol is K. Amount of substance will be represented in mole. The symbol will be MOL here. And then luminous intensity will be in terms of candela. So the symbol is CD. Along with this basic units, one more two units are there. What we call that? Nothing but angles. One is a plane angle, another is solid angle. Plane angle and then solid angle. So plane angle nothing but always this will be taken from the sphere. Whenever you consider a solid sphere, whenever you are cutting the sphere, then what we can get? What we can get there? A solid cone you will get, right? From the sphere, whenever you are cutting the sphere, for example, you are just taking a part of the sphere. Let me take, this is the sphere, and in that I am just taking this part. So that what I can form here? Solid cone. So that for that solid cone will have the solid angle. That solid angle will be measured in terms of steradian. Okay, plane angle will be represented whenever you take the circular motion. Plane angle will be represented in terms of what? Radians. Radians and then steradians. Plane angle means radians, and then solid angle nothing but steradians. So mainly which is more useful for us, nothing but this SI units for the fundamental physical quantities. Those are mass will be represented in kg like that, and then all the seven quantities will represent in terms of this one, and then symbols are this. And also the three types of system of units are CGS, FPS and then MKS. So CGS nothing but centimeter, gram and then second, foot, pound and then second, and also meters, meters and then kg and then second. Those are the different system of units, in that which is acceptable around the world, SI unit is acceptable, so that all will measure in terms of SI units only. So only whenever we are teaching, at that time we will be saying that what is the SI unit of work, what is the SI unit of energy, that and all. So that standard international units are acceptable throughout the world. Clear, right? Copy whatever I have written there, you copy. Supplementary physical quantities, plane angle and then solid angle. What is the plane angle formula? Angle is equals to what? Theta is equals to? Arc length by radius, right? Theta is equals to what we can write? Arc length by radius. In the same way, Here solid angle nothing but area by radius square. Finished, huh? In this units, basic units, one more concept will be there. Conversion of units, the conversion factor. The conversion factor. First of all, how to represent a physical quantity? How to represent a physical, I want to represent the length. How to represent that? For example, I'm having so and so from here to there, this much of length is there. How to represent that? Length nothing but anything, any physical quantity, how to represent nothing but that is, you just multiply the number with along with what? Units only, right? I say that this length is 10 meters. 10 is a number and then meters is nothing but what? Unit. Any physical quantity, that might be any physical quantity, you have to represent as number into the number of units here. Into the units. For example, if I say a mass of this marker is, let me take 100 grams. 100 grams nothing but 100 is a number, grams is what? Unit of the mass only. So anything, any physical quantity you have to represent means you have to give the physical quantity is equal to, that might be anything, the number of times how many it is repeating, and also the basic unit you have to take. Length nothing but I say 10 meters. 1 meter is repeating how many times, sir? 10 times. So I will take a meter square scale and then I will just repeat the measurement. So that what will get here? 10 meters will get. So the physical quantity will be represented in terms of number and then units. So here any physical quantity, we can say it as just n into u only. Here u represent what? Units. Now the conversion factor, for example, I want to convert 1 kg into so and so grams. How many grams you will get? 1000 grams obviously. So we will try that. So first of all, I said that any physical quantity, here what we are representing, the physical quantity of mass. Mass we are representing in 1 kg. Here 1 is what? Number. And then unit in one system. Here again one number you will get, that unit in the other system. So that n1 u1 is equals to n2 u2. So n1 is how much we got already? 1 kg. 1 into unit is how much? Kg is equals to, n2 is, I don't know the value of n2. For that n2 into grams we have to take. Let me take here, instead of 1 I will take it as 10 kg. Okay, then 10 kg is equals to how many grams I am asking here. So that n2 is equals to what I can write? 10 divided by kg, 10 into kg by grams. So that 10 into 1 kg is equals to how many grams you will take? 1000 grams. So that 1000 grams divided by grams, grams cancel, then what will get here? 10 power 4 you will get, 10,000. So that is the n2. This is the conversion factor. Whenever you want to convert one system of units to other system of units, nothing but of the same physical quantity, by the way, at that time you have to multiply with some number, some factor you have to multiply with. That factor value is how much here? 10 power 4. I'm saying that 10 kg I'm converting into so and so grams. So I have to multiply with how much number? Nothing but I have to multiply with 10 power 4. That is the conversion factor here. Clear, right? For example, I want to measure the 5 meters length in terms of centimeters. I have to say, in terms of centimeter, nothing but how many you'll take? 500 centimeters, right? Already you know that. Already we know that. But the thing is, you have to remember here, n1 u1 is equals to n2 u2. N1 u1 is what? Given quantity. And then n2 u2 nothing but what? The unknown quantity we have to find out here. So that n1 is 10 kg they have given here also. N1 value is how much here? 5. And then meters is equals to n2, I don't know. What is the u2 here? Centimeter. So that n2 is equals to 5 into 1 meter is equals to how many centimeters? 100 centimeter by centimeter. So that what will get here? N2 is equals to 500, whatever you said. So that we call as what? Conversion factor. You want to convert one system to another system, nothing but you have to multiply with some number. That number is known as what? Conversion factor here. Always the physical quantity should be represented in terms of what? The number of times it is repeating and also along with units. That is a basic representation of physical quantity. Write that. The representation of physical quantity is, the representation of physical quantity is, the representation of physical quantity is the product of number of times it is repeating. The product of number of times it is repeating and its unit. Write that. Physical quantity is equals to n into u. Physical quantity is equals to n into units, that is nu. The next line you write, for converting one system of units to other system of units, nu is equals to constant. Nu is equals to constants. Then n1 u1 is equals to n2 u2. N1 u1 is equals to n2 u2. See, why nu is equals to constant I said means, for example, I said that length from here to there is 10 meters. If I measure with the centimeter scale, is there any change in that value? Is there any change in that value? Can the distance will be changed? No. Whenever you are just measuring with the normal balance, at that time 1 kg it is reading. Whenever you are just balancing with this digital balance, at that time it is showing 1000 grams. Is there any change in the quantity? Nothing is changing. So only what I said, nu is always constant only. The quantity remains constant only. However, you are just representing in terms of other values, but the quantity will be always remains. 1 kg means in 1000 grams also, in tons also, in quintals also, we can represent only 1 kg only. But the representation is changing. But the quantity is same only. For example, if I say your weight is 50 kg, nothing but in terms of kg, I say that it has 50 kg. In terms of grams, I say that is 5000 grams, 50,000 grams. In terms of quintal, I say that half quintal. I can represent in different units, but what your weight is same only, 50 kg only. Clear, right? So that in that way, whenever you are just changing the system of units also, the quantity will not change. Quantity will remains constant. So only I said nu is equals to much constant. So only n1 u1 is equals to n2 u2 will take. For example, in grams I said, in quintals also I can take n3 u3 like that. So any number of units you can take, but the quantity remains constant only. Again, you take a look here. Physical quantities are basically two types. One is fundamental, another is derived quantities. Fundamental nothing but basic fundamental quantities are mass, length, time, electric current, temperature, amount of substance and then luminous intensity. Whatever you are representing in physics, that will be in terms of this all. Anything, that might be anything. For example, you are talking about the force, nothing but force is nothing but what? What is the force for us? Mass into acceleration. acceleration is again in terms of what, meter per second square. However, whatever you represent, for example, you are just measuring the voltage. Voltage nothing but V is equal to what will take? I into R, that again in terms of current only. Anything. Temperature you are reading nothing but in terms of basic physical quantities only will tell. So anything, all the quantities in physics will be represented in terms of these quantities. Those are the mass, length, time, electric current, temperature, amount of substance and luminous intensity. So basically these three are main major quantities, so that mass, length, time will be represented in three different system of units. One is the CGS system of unit, FPS and then MKS. Centimeter, centimeter, gram and then second. So length should be in centimeter, mass should be in grams and then time should be in seconds. That is about the CGS system. Next, FPS system. FPS nothing but whenever you go to the Russia like that, they will measure in terms of pounds and all. So in that FPS system nothing but this is length will be foot and then this one mass will be in terms of pound and then time will be in terms of seconds. Next, MKS system. Before SI system, MKS system was there. So that MKS system nothing but this is a meter, kg and then second. After that, all over the world, one system of unit was there, that is all over the world, one system of unit is accepted, that is a standard international systems. So that standard international system given definition for the all the physical quantities here, not only three. All the remaining system of units, how many quantities it has taken? Only three quantities, right? So but this one is given definition for the all the physical quantities. So mass will be represented in terms of kg, length will be represented in terms of what? Meters. Time will be represented in terms of seconds, electric current will be ampere, temperature in Kelvin and also amount of substance in mole and then luminous intensity will be in terms of candela. In this SI units only, along with this fundamental physical quantities, two more supplementary quantities are there. Those are plane angle and then solid angle. Plane angle nothing but any body is moving on a circumference of the circle. At that time, what is making? Which displacement? Angular displacement. That angle is plane angle. So plane angle formula is what for us? Arc length by radius only. So that what we can say here, L divided by R, distance divided by R we can take. So how to represent the plane angle? Nothing but radians. The symbol will be RAD. Always we will take omega nothing but what in terms of radian per second we will take. So that RAD is the symbol. Next, steradian. Steradian means it is not useful for you, for the IIT advanced it will be useful. Steradian nothing but whenever you are taking just a part of the solid cylinder. Whenever you take the part of the circle, at that time what I am getting here? Plane angle. Whenever you take the part of the cylinder, at that time what will get? Cone. For that cone, solid angle will be there. That solid angle formula is what here? Area divided by distance square will get. Area by R square. And then not R square, that is a radius square, area divided by radius square. Area of the cone will be different, so that area by radius square. Then that how to represent that nothing but in terms of steradian, the symbol will be SR here. And also for the physical quantities, mainly one factor will be there, that is a conversion factor. To convert one system of units to another system of units, you have to multiply with one number. That number is called as what? Conversion factor. Always, how to represent the physical quantity nothing but you have to take the number of times it is repeated and also along with the units you have to take, so that only physical quantity is equals to n into u have taken. If you represent in terms of kg otherwise grams, the quantity will not changes, the entire mass of the body will not changes. If you represent in terms of grams, it will not become this much, correct? So whatever before size is there, this after also same thing will be there. So that physical quantity will never depends on the change in the units. So that will be always constant only. So that constant means nu is equals to constant we'll take here. Nu is constant. That nu is constant means what I can write? Simply n1 u1 is equals to n2 u2. Anything we can represent from one system to another system by just multiplying a conversion factor. So that is about the basic units. Next, dimensions. This one is important, dimensions is important and very easy chapter which will give you around 4 to 8 marks. 1 to 2 questions will come from this chapter only. One is from the dimensions, another is from the errors. Very small chapter, but very, very easy. Next, dimensions. What do you mean by dimensions? Always you will write dimensional formula, right? What you will do there? In dimensional formula, what we are doing? What is the dimensional formula of the force? Tell me. M L T power minus 2. What we are doing here? We are taking a physical quantity, that is force. Which physical quantity? Fundamental or derived? Force is which quantity? Derived quantity. We are taking the derived quantity, or it might be fundamental quantity also. There is no problem in that. But always, whenever you are representing a physical quantity, for that what you are doing? Nothing but you are raising the powers of the fundamental quantities. See that mass, length, time are what? Fundamental quantities only. You are just raising the mass power and then length power and then time power. We are representing a physical quantity by raising the powers of the fundamental quantities. Any physical quantity, for example, if I say I am representing the acceleration. Acceleration is what? M0 L T power minus 2. Meter per second square only, right? So that M0 L into T power minus 2. L nothing but L power 1. I have taken a physical quantity which is what? Acceleration. To represent that, what I am doing? I am raising the powers of what here? Mass, length and then time. What are that mass, length and time? Fundamental quantities. To represent a physical quantity, we are raising the powers of the basic physical quantities, fundamental physical quantities. So that is known as what? Dimensions. Anything you want to represent in terms of dimension, nothing but you have to take the basic quantities as mass, length and then time, and along with that remaining will also will come. Whenever you are just talking about the electric field, at that time amperes also will come. That we will discuss in there. Now, here any physical quantity are representing just raising the powers of the fundamental quantities. That is called as dimension. In that dimensions, very, very important applications will be there. One is to find out the, to check the correctness first of all. Checking the correctness of physical quantity. And I think what? For example, if I say S is equals to UT minus 1 by 3 into AT square. Tell me that that is correct or not? S is equal to, what is our formula? UC plus, UT plus half AT square. But here what we are getting? UT minus 1 by 3 into AT square. That is correct or wrong? Wrong. Physically wrong, but dimensionally it is correct. So to check the dimensions, we have to use the dimension. To check the physical quantity, you have to use the dimensions. And also to convert one system to another system. For conversion, for knowing the unknown value, unknown physical quantity. These and all are the basic applications of the dimensional formulas. Any dimensional formula, nothing but what you have to do, you have to take the physical quantity and then you have to raise the powers of which one? Powers of fundamental physical quantities, which are what? Mass, length and then time, even ampere and also temperature, anything it might be. But you have to take a quantity and then you have to raise the powers of the fundamental quantities. So, different applications will be there for the dimensions, dimensional formulas. One is checking the correctness of a physical quantity. And also another is converting one system to another system. For example, if I say 1 Newton, you have to convert into dyne. Dynes is which system? CGS system. You have to convert 1 Newton from SI to dyne, you have to convert SI system to CGS units. For that also dimensional formulas will be used. And also, for knowing the unknown physical quantities. For example, if I represent the time period of a satellite in terms of acceleration due to gravity, gravitational constant, mass and then radius. How to represent this time in terms of this and all? Generally, time in terms of small g and L, how we'll represent? T is equal to 2 pi into under root L by g. In the same way, by using these quantities, how to represent the time value? That formulas we will do. Okay. And also, for example, they say that velocity you have to represent in terms of pressure, acceleration, something or whatever it might be. You have to represent one unknown quantity in terms of known quantities. Here I don't know the T. T I have to represent in terms of L and G. How to represent in terms of L and G? T is equals to 2 pi under root L by G we will get. You have to represent the Planck's constant in terms of energy and frequency. How to represent that? E is equals to h nu only, right? Then h is equals to E divided by nu we will get. This is how I am representing the Planck's constant in terms of energy and then frequency. This is how I am representing the time in terms of length and then acceleration due to gravity. How can we represent the time in terms of the universal gravitational constant, mass of the planet and then radius of the planet? How to represent that? That we will do. Okay. That is how we have to get to know the unknown physical quantities. Correct. In this basically one law will be there, that is principle of homogeneity. What is that principle of homogeneity? Any idea about that? That is very, very important. Very, very important to do all of these applications. Principle of homogeneity. LHS is equal to RHS. That's not principle of homogeneity. Here, physical quantities can be added or subtracted whenever they are having the same dimensions. You understand that? Physical quantities can be added or subtracted whenever they have same dimensions. For example, I have V is equals to U plus AT formula. Here what I am doing here? U and then AT. What I am doing for U and AT? I am just adding. Whenever I am adding, they should have the same dimensions. Let us check it will have the same dimensions or not. First of all, U I will take. What is the U dimensions? Dimensions of U is what? Lt power minus 2. So that Lt power minus 1, I am sorry. Minus 1. Then I am adding with what? Acceleration and then time. So that At dimensions are what? So A is nothing but what? Lt power minus 2. And then T is nothing but what? T only. Then one of the T, one of the D gets cancelled here, Lt power minus 1. Understand, right? Both are having same dimensions here. Both are having same dimensions. So only I am adding them. We can add, we can subtract, or even we can equate whenever they are having the same dimensions. Clear, right? Otherwise, one more thing is there for us. Basic force formula is what? Basic formula. M into A plus V into dm by dt. Is that correct? Mass into acceleration plus V into dm by dt. How we got that? From the Newton's second law. F is equal to what is the formula? Dp by dt. From the D into mv we have taken and then we have applied U and V formula. And then from here I have added ma and then V dm by dt. Let us check they are having the same dimensions or not. So that ma. Mass nothing but what I can take here? Capital M. Acceleration nothing but what we can take? L into t power minus 2. So this is the dimension formula I have got for the ma. Next v dm by dt we'll see. V dm by dt. Velocity nothing but what? L t power minus 1. Dm nothing but what? Mass only, right? Mass is m divided by t nothing but what? Time seconds. So that here what you are getting again? M l seconds nothing but what? T. And then t power minus 2. We are getting the same formula or not? Same dimensional formula. So only I am able to add them. And also this force also, what is the formula for the force? Dimensional formula ml t power minus 2. I am able to add here and then I am able to equate. Even I can able to subtract also. For example, here velocity is negative velocity. Otherwise mass is decreasing. At that time what will you get here? Minus. We are able to subtract here. Otherwise, we are able to add here. Otherwise, we are able to equate here. Whenever they are having same dimensional formula. That is the principle of homogeneity. Anywhere if you see plus and minus, simply you take them as separate and then you just equate them. That's it. Clear, right? While doing the problems. We will do the problems, however. In that, right there. First of all, principle of homogeneity. Dimensions. 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 To represent a physical quantity, to represent a physical quantity, we have to raise the powers of fundamental physical quantities. We have to raise the powers of fundamental physical quantities. In that, first of all, write one side fundamental quantities. All the fundamental quantities you write. All the fundamental quantities you write one side. Mass, length, time, current, temperature, and next, amount of substance, then luminous intensity. Mass, length, time, current, temperature, amount of substance, and then luminous intensity. The dimensions of these are, dimensions another side. What's the dimension of mass? Capital M. Dimension of length is what? L. Dimension of time is what? T. Dimension of current is what? Capital A. Ampere. Capital A. Dimension of temperature is what? Kelvin K. Molarity is just MOL. And then next, candela is just, you have to take it as CD. These are the dimensional representations of basic physical quantities. Dimensional representation of basic physical quantities. M, L, T, A, K, mole, and then CD. Whenever you are writing any dimensional formula, you have to use only these quantities. In terms of these quantities only, you have to raise the power. That might be 1, 2 or 3, anything. Nothing is there, nothing but what we have to take? 0. In case of velocity, what is the dimensional formula of velocity? L t power minus 1 only. Is that velocity is depending on the mass? Mass is, velocity is equal to what is the formula? Displacement by time. It is depending only on displacement and then time only. So only in the dimensional formula, you'll never get the mass. So that always m power 0, l power 1, t power minus 2. Next, applications of homogeneity finished. The principle of homogeneity? No, right? Write that. Principle of homogeneity. Principle of homogeneity. Physical quantities can be added, physical quantities can be added, subtracted, or equated. Physical quantities can be added, subtracted, or equated when they have same dimensions. When they have same dimensions. Example, V is equals to U plus AT. V is equals to U plus AT. In the next line, you write U and AT. U and AT are added so that they have same dimensional formula. Copy this. Next, applications of dimensional formulas. Applications of dimensional formulas. First one, applications of dimensional formulas. First one, checking the correctness of a physical quantity. Checking the correctness of a physical quantity. Next one, conversion of physical quantity from one system of units to another system of units. Next one, representing dimensional formula of an unknown physical quantity Yeah, just to miss the opportunity. You're going to Martha is already. Enough, Saka? Salpa rest to Kodabeka. Salpa water Kodabeka. What is the last one I said, right? Then, next one, first one. Checking the correctness of a physical quantity. Checking the correctness of a physical quantity. V square minus U square is equals to 10 AS. V square minus U square is equals to 10 AS. Whenever you are checking the any physical quantity, nothing but at that time you have to get the dimensions in the left side is equals to dimensions in the right side you have to get. So here V square minus U square is equals to 10 AS I have. So you know that is already wrong. V square minus U square is equals to how much you will get? 2 AS. So that is physically, however, it is wrong only. You already know that. Let us check it is dimensionally correct or not. So for that, first of all, V square nothing but velocity, right? Velocity here, I'm just subtracting this. Subtracting nothing but what is the meaning of that from the principle of homogeneity? Both will have same dimensions. So V square and U square will have same dimensions. Let us check that. Velocity nothing but what here? V square is equals to L t power minus 1 whole square. So that what will get here? L square t power minus 2. That is the V square value. Automatically, whenever you are subtracting nothing but U square also will have the same thing only. So that U square also will have L square t power minus 2 only. In the right side, we'll check. This is the left hand side. Left hand side will get U square is equals to also what you will get? L square t power minus 2. Don't say that L square t power minus 2 minus L square t power minus 2 is 0. Correct? You cannot say like that. You can add and then subtract whenever they are having. Most of the people, almost 70% of the people, okay, left side will get 0 and then right side will not get, so that it is dimensionally also wrong. So you cannot subtract this one powers directly. L square minus t power minus 2. L square minus t power minus 2 means that is in whenever you are doing mathematical calculations, that is 0. Now you no need to take that. This entire thing is representing as how much? Nothing but L square t power minus 2. This is what v square minus u square nothing but the difference of the squares of the velocity only. So difference of squares of velocity gives you what again? Square of velocity only. For example, 10 meters minus 5 meters gives you how much? 5 meters only again. Okay, you say you if you take and then 10 common meter minus meter is 0. You cannot tell like that, right? So that see this is difference of the squares of the velocities again gives you the difference of the square of velocity only. So that here v square or u square is how much here? L square t power minus 2. Then right side when we'll check RHS we'll check. RHS is 10 into a into s. Is there any dimensions for 10? There is no dimensions for the numbers, angles, also you have to take the angles and logarithms and then exponents. For all this and all, there will be no dimension. Those are the dimensionless quantities. All the numbers, whatever we take, all the natural numbers, otherwise all the decimal numbers, everything are dimensionless. All the trigonometric functions are dimensionless and also all the logarithm functions, all the exponential functions, all are dimensionless only. So here, right side we are having 10 as, 10 is dimensionless however, then acceleration and then displacement. Acceleration is what? L into t power minus 2 into, displacement is how much here? L. So what will you get here? L square t power minus 2. Are we getting same or different? Left side also L square t power minus 2, right side also L square t power minus 2. So what I can say, this formula is dimensionally correct but physically it is wrong. Why? Because the correct formula is what? V square minus u square is equals to 2as. Here one more example I can give as t is equals to, I can say that 2 into root l by g. Not 2 into root l by g, that is 10 into root l by g. Tell me that it is dimensionally correct or physically correct? Dimensionally correct. Physically what is the formula? 2 pi into root l by g. However, it might be 2 pi, otherwise it might be 10, otherwise it might be 10 lakhs. That number will not affect the dimensional formula. Why? Because number is a dimensionless quantity there. So that here, t is equals to L nothing but what? Length nothing but L. And then g is nothing but what? L t power minus 2 whole power how much here? 1 by 2 under root means. Then what we can say here? L power 1 by 2 and then L power minus 1 t power minus 2 whole power 1 by 2. Understanding right what I am doing here? So here L power 1 by 2 I have taken. L t power minus 2 I got into the numerator. So that what happening here? L power minus 2, this will become how much? Plus 2. Whole power how much is there again? 1 by 2 is there. Then L power 1 by 2 into, this one is what? L power minus 1 by 2 and t power 2 by 2. L power minus 1 by 2, L power plus 1 by 2. L power 0 and what is remaining here? T power 1 is remaining. Left side also what we are getting here? T power 1 only. So we got left hand side and then right hand side same dimensions. So what I can say, this one is dimensionally correct but physically it is wrong. Clear? That is how we will check the physical quantity, correctness of the physical quantity by using the dimensions. It is correct or not. Clear, right? Copy that, those two examples. Check the correctness of, check the correctness of v square minus u square is equals to 10 as, v square minus u square is equals to 10 as. And second question, in that only, t is equals to 10 under root L by G. T is equals to 10 under root L by G. इधर क्यों बैठे रहे तू? इधर जाना था ना? दिख रहा है इधर से बोर्ड? ఏం టిఫిన్ ఇవ్వదు హాస్టల్లో చిత్రాన్న సౌని చిత్ర విచిత్రవాగి నింతె మార్తా ఇద్దరు ఎల్లరూ ఏం ప్రజలు బతికే ఉన్నావా And tomorrow onwards, I'll take the class at 8:30, 9:30, 10:30 to 11:30. I'll take for your class. Today, Mohin sir came, no? At that time, I'll come. 10:30 to 12, ah? 10:30 to 12. 12 to 1:30 is the next hour, right? Afternoon, I'll take one class. Mohin sir will take another class. I'll take one class alternate day for you. For you today, one class came nothing but for them, it will come tomorrow like that. And also, whoever are late comers are there, and then from effective today onwards, I'm going to start that lagging chapters. Today, I guess most probably I'll start today only vectors start first and foremost. And after that, I'll discuss the straight line and then plane. Whoever came lately, just attend to the classes there. Okay, na? Finished our two problems? Yes. Next application is what? Conversion of one system of units to another system of units. Right, that next application. Altogether, we'll solve the number of problems again. Basically, we'll solve one or two problems based on these applications. Right, that conversion of one system of units to another system of units. Conversion of one system of units to another system of units. Convert 1 Newton into dyne. Convert the force from SI units to CGS units. Convert force from SI units to CGS units. So how much? Generally already we know that, but we'll prove again. 1 Newton is equal to how much? 10 power 5 dynes. 1 joule is equal to how many arcs? 10 power 7 arcs. Okay, that we'll do first of all. 1 Newton. Newton nothing but without using the dimensional formula, I'll tell you the easy method to do this. So I'll not use the dimensional formula. However, this is application only, but there is no need to use the dimensional formula. Here Newton nothing but what we can say? What is the force formula? Mass into acceleration. Mass into acceleration nothing but mass is kg. Acceleration is meter per second square. That is equals to 1 kg is equals to, you have to get this one in terms of CGS. This is a CGS unit. CGS unit nothing but you have to get the kg in terms of what? Grams. So 1 kg is equal to how many grams? 1000 grams. And then 1 meter is equal to how many centimeters? 100 centimeters. And then second is second only, as it is second square, we'll write. So that here 10 power 3 and then 10 power 2, how much it is? 10 power 5 gram per centimeter per second square. This gram per centimeter per second square is nothing but a dyne. That's it. This is the 1 Newton can be represented as how much? Nothing but 10 power 5 dynes. Okay, otherwise 1 dyne is equal to 10 power minus 5 Newtons. Anything is correct only. Again, if you take in terms of joule and then arc, 1 joule is equal to how many arcs we'll see. Joule nothing but what? Energy or work done. So what is the formula for us? Force into displacement. Already force, how much we got? Kg meter per second square. Into displacement is again what? Into meter. So that what I can write here? Kg meter square per second square. Force into displacement only. Force is kg meter per second square. And then here this one is into meter, means kg meter square per second square. So that you have to represent in terms of ergs. Erg is again CGS unit only. 1 kg is equals to again how much? 1000 grams. 1 meter is equals to 10 power 2 centimeter. But here 10 m square is there, no? So what you have to take? 10 power 4 centimeter square. That divided by second square is as it is. So that this will be how much? 10 power 7 gram per centimeter square per second square. So 10 power 7, what I can write it as? Ergs. 1 joule is equal to 10 power 7 ergs. Clear? Copy that. टाइम आता लंच टाइम हाफ सेवा।